Hello dear students and welcome to the online session of Akoos English Medium School. Today we are going to study subject science for the 7th standard and chapter heat. So in this, what we are going to study in this chapter? First, what is heat? So who will tell me what is heat? Yes, heat is the form of energy. Heat is the form of energy. Then what is energy? Energy is capacity to do work. Energy is capacity to do work. Now, heat is the form of energy. Energy is capacity to do work. Then the question comes, what is work done? What is work? So, work is said to be done when the applied force causes the displacement in the direction of force. It means that work done is equal to mathematically force into displacement. It means that when you apply heat, work is going to be completed or work will be done. How so? Have you observed your mother cooking in the kitchen? And if suppose she is cooking rice in the vessel, you might observe that she has covered that vessel with the lid. After some time, what happens? You will see the movement of the lid. Lid is going upward. How it happens means, this is the vessel and she is cooking the food, she is applying the heat and she is covering this vessel with the lid. What happens? After some time, these vapor try to push this lid upward. So there is a displacement, and how it happened? Because of the applied heat. So heat causes the work. So work is done here. So heat is necessary to do the work because heat is the form of energy. Okay, then how you are going to say whether a substance is hot or cold? How you judge whether a substance is hot or cold? By touching it. Suppose I give you this bow and I will tell me whether it is hot or cold. What you will do? You will touch it, and by touching you will say that whether it is a hot or cold. So whether a substance is hot or cold is just by the sense of touch. But is the sense of touch a reliable method? Is it? Every time you will touch it, you will say that whether a substance is hot or cold. Is it reliable? So let us perform one small activity. You have to perform the same activity at your home also. So here I am having three bow. Here I am having three bow A, B and C. In this bow I have hot water. In this I have chilled cold water. And this I am having normal water. So what I will do? I am dipping my hand in the cold water and hot water simultaneously. My right hand in cold water and my left hand in hot water. I will remain in this position for 1 minute. After 1 minute, I will insert my both the hand simultaneously in the normal water. Now, what I am feeling that my right hand, which was dipped into the cold water, now when I insert in the normal water, now it is feeling heat, and which was dipped in the hot water, now it is feeling cold. How it happened? My right hand, which was dipped in the cold water, after dipping it in the normal water, it started getting the heat from the normal water. And my hand, which was dipped earlier into the hot water, now it started losing the heat. So that's why, which was earlier feeling heat, now feeling cold, and which was earlier feeling cold, now feeling hot. It means that heat, sense of touch, is not the reliable method to say whether a substance is hot or cold. It may mislead you. Then how you are going to say? Then you have to measure the temperature. So what is next point is temperature. What is temperature? Temperature is the measure of degree of hotness or coldness of a substance. And SI unit of temperature is Kelvin. SI unit of temperature, SI unit of temperature is curving, which is denoted by K. So SI unit of temperature is Kelvin. There are other two scales also to measure the temperature, that is Celsius, degree Celsius scale, and degree Fahrenheit scale. So SI unit is Kelvin denoted by K. Other two are Celsius and degree Fahrenheit. There is a relation between Celsius and Fahrenheit, so which I am going to discuss later on when I am telling you the So as I have discussed, the temperature is the measure of degree of hotness or coldness of a substance. Now how to measure the temperature? So instrument used to measure the temperature is called as thermometer. I hope all of you might have seen clinical thermometer. All of you might have visited the doctor's clinic, and there you have seen this thermometer, which is known as clinical thermometer. If this thermometer is available at your home, please do observe this thermometer and just take care. You have to hold this thermometer very carefully. And if you see this thermometer carefully, you will find out the temperatures are in degree Celsius and in Fahrenheit also. And here is one red mark. I will have one detailed lecture on thermometer. Here one, there is one red mark, and there is mark 37 degrees Celsius. So our normal body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. Okay. So, and here below the scale is Fahrenheit scale. There is a relation between Celsius scale and Fahrenheit scale, which I will be discussing in detail. I will be solving some examples also, how to convert the temperature in degree Celsius to Fahrenheit and temperature in Fahrenheit to degree Celsius. Okay, so there are two types of thermometer. One is the clinical thermometer and another is the laboratory thermometer. Both I am going to discuss in detail in a special lecture for the thermometer, a detailed lecture on thermometer. Now we are going to see modes of transfer of heat. Just now I have explained you through this activity how the heat was transferred. Okay, so what are the modes of transfer of heat? So there are three modes of transfer of heat. Which are those? Number one, conduction. Number two, convection. And number three is radiation. Let us discuss each of them one by one. So first I am going to discuss the conduction. What is conduction? Now this word conduction, from where it comes? Conductor. Do you remember last in the 6th standard you studied conductors and insulator related to electricity? So what we have studied in electricity chapter? A substance which conduct electricity are the conductor, and which do not conduct electricity are insulators. Same here in this heat chapter, the substance which conduct the heat are the conductors, and the substance which do not conduct the heat are the insulators. So all the metals are the mostly conductors. So here I am having one metal strip, aluminum strip. It means that this is a metal, it is conductor, it is going to conduct the heat. And this is a wood which is used as an insulator. Okay, so I will perform one more experiment, a small activity to understand the conduction. Before performing that activity, let us understand what is conduction. Conduction is the mode of transfer of heat in which the heat is transferred from the point at higher temperature to the point at lower temperature without the actual movement of the particle. I repeat, conduction is the process of transfer of heat in which heat is transferred from the point at higher temperature to the point at lower temperature without the actual movement of the particle. And conduction occurs in solids. So let us understand. So suppose I am having a metal rod and I'm holding here and I'm hitting one end with the help of the burner, one end of the conductors. Even you can perform this. Suppose you are holding one end of the rod in your hand and you are hitting the another end. Okay, what will happen? Slowly you will start feeling heat here. Now you are hitting this end A, but you are feeling after some time heat at B. How it became possible? Does this particle move from this point to this point? No. All of us know that all the substances are made up of molecules. Especially in solids, the molecules are very close to each other. So here, all the molecules are close to each other. And in the beginning only, we have studied that heat is the form of energy. Means when you apply heat, energy is given. Same happens what happens when the heat is applied, these molecules get the energy. And what happens? They start vibrating. Okay? They start vibrating. And when they start vibrating, as they are closely held to each other, they kick each other. Now kicking, so these molecule will vibrate and they will kick other molecule, they will get heat. So this process continues and all these molecules get heat and these heats get transferred up to here. But this molecule will not move there. This will vibrate at their mean position only. Just example, many times while in assembly, all of you are standing in a queue. What happens if someone pulls you? So someone jerks you. What happens? Entire line get disturbed. Means all of you feel the little force. Same thing happens here. When the heat is applied here, the molecules starts vibrating because as they get energy, because heat is the form of energy. And what happens? Then all these molecules get heat and slowly you feel heat here because heat is being transferred from point A to the point B by the method of conduction without actual movement of the particle. This is very important. So this is conduction, and conduction occurs in solid mostly. Okay, then another is convection. Convection is the process of transfer of heat from the body at higher temperature to the body at lower temperature with actual movement of the particle. So very interesting, in conduction there is no actual movement of the particle, but in convection there is an actual movement of the particle. Now how you are going to understand this convection? Now for that you have to see when your mother is hitting the water or she is making the tea, she has kept the water in the teapot on the gas stove and she is hitting it. You will observe that this is the vessel in which she has kept the water. What you are going to observe? Heat is being applied here. These molecules you have to observe very clearly. First you will find after some time a small bubble type, pulse like structure will form, and it will, after heat it up, it will move up. It will move up, it will come up. It will get heat, it will come up. So what happened? There is a movement of the water molecule. There is a movement of water molecule and this layer will get heated, it will move up. Then again, the other molecule will occupy this position and this process will continue. This will continue until they reach in the equilibrium condition, and then if you apply more heat, then this process continues and then you see the boiling of water. So this is the convection. You have to keep in mind that convection is the process of transfer of heat from the body at higher temperature to the body at lower temperature with the actual movement of the particle. So this is the convection. This also the media is necessary. In conduction also there were media must be necessary. Media was necessary, there was conducting media. In convection also medium is necessary for the transfer of heat. Now the last one is a radiation. Very interesting. What is radiation? Radiation is the process of transfer of heat from the body at higher temperature to the body at lower temperature without any medium. No media is necessary. Just imagine the sun is so far away from us we are on the earth, but how we receive heat, how we feel heat, how we feel hot in the sunny day, how it is possible? Because all of you know that there is a vacuum between the for a long distance between the sun and the earth. There is no conducting media, there is no media, but still we feel hot because of the process of radiation. Means the for the process of radiation, the transfer of heat by the process of radiation, we do not need any media. And this radiation process is a continuous process. It always happens. For example, this is the thermos. Suppose this, in this bottle there is a water, and the water was a cold, but after some time what happened, this water temperature becomes normal. How so? Because the heat is being transferred from the sources to this bottle. It got the heat. How it got? Radiation, by the radiation. For example, your mother has given you the tea cup of tea, you have not taken it, you have taken it late, and when you have taken it late, you feel that the tea is now cold. How it happens? How it lost the its temperature? Because of the here the all will come, conduction and radiation, both will come. So for the radiation we do not need any media for the transfer of heat. Okay, understood all of you? Conduction, convection and radiation. Okay, so I taught you how we measure the temperature. Reservoir is Kelvin, and other two scales of measuring temperature are Celsius and degree Fahrenheit. Let us see the relation between degree Celsius and Fahrenheit. So if the temperature is given in degree Celsius, and if you want to convert it into degree Fahrenheit, you have to keep in mind one relation. Temperature in Fahrenheit is equal to temperature in Fahrenheit is equal to 9/5 into temperature in degree Celsius plus 32. Temperature in degree Celsius plus 32. So this is the equation that you have to keep in mind. Okay, so F is equal to, what is the equation? F is equal to 9/5 into temperature in degree Celsius plus 32. From this equation we have to solve few examples. So I will take examples from the book. So in the book there is one example. Convert 77 degree Fahrenheit. Convert 45 degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit. What is the question? Convert 45 degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit. So this is the question. Convert 45 degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit. So how we are going to solve? So here the temperature is given in Celsius. So what is C? C is equal to 45. What is C? C is equal to 45. What you want? You want temperature in degree Fahrenheit. Degree Fahrenheit. You know the expression that F is equal to 9/5 into temperature in degree Celsius plus 32. Just put the value of C. So therefore F is equal to 9/5 into C, which is 45 plus 32. So let us solve it. 5 is a numerator, 45 here in the numerator. In the numerator nothingness it was. So 5 ones are and 5 nines are. Okay, 5 nines are 45. Okay, so what will happen? Now you get in bracket 9 into 9 plus 32. Add it. 9 into 9, 81 plus 32. Just add it. 1 plus 2, 3. 8 plus 3, 11. Carry 1. So 130 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, so you got the temperature. So it means that 45 degrees Celsius is equal to 130 degree Fahrenheit. What it means? 45 degrees Celsius is equal to 130 degree Fahrenheit. Let us see one more example. Here we may have to convert the temperature in Fahrenheit into degree Celsius. Let us take one more question. Convert, the question is, convert 77 degree Fahrenheit, convert 77 degree Fahrenheit to degree Celsius. Okay, now you may by heart the separate expression for the temperature in degree Celsius. Otherwise, if you know only this formula, by using this also, we can solve if your maths is good. So see here, now the temperature is given in Fahrenheit. So F is equal to what? 77, given to you. And you want temperature in degree Celsius. By the same equation, you can solve or you can use this equation. C is equal to, I will tell you both the equation. C is equal to 5 by 9 into F minus 13. You can use this equation also, or by using this equation only you can solve. So let us solve. So I want temperature in degree Celsius. F is equal to 77. So 77 is equal to 9 by 5 into C as it is plus 13. Okay. What we know, you first solve the bracket. So the bracket C is unknown, so keep this bracket as it is. This plus 32 is on right hand side. Try to bring it on left hand side. So what will happen? On right hand side it is in plus. When I bring it left hand side, it will become minus. What will happen? 77 minus 32 is equal to 9 by 5 into C. Okay? Do the subtraction. So we get 7 minus 2, 5, 7 minus 3, 4. So 45 is equal to 9 by 5 into C. 9 by 5 into C. Okay? So I am interchanging the sign. 9 by 5 into C is equal to 45. I want C. Okay? Let us go step by step. This 5 is in denominator. Let me send this 5 on the right hand side, it will become numerator. On left hand side, division mein hai, toh wahan jayega, right hand mein kya hoga? Multiplication. So what will happen? 9c is equal to 45 into 5. Okay? So what will happen? C is equal to, now 9 will go that side, so it will become denominator. So 45 into 5 upon 9. 9 ones are 9, 5. So what do you get? C is equal to 5 into 5. So C is equal to 25. Understood? C is equal to 25 degrees Celsius. It means that 77 degree Fahrenheit, 77 degree Fahrenheit is equal to 25 degree Celsius. Understood? Suppose if you use that formula directly which I have written on that side, that is C is equal to F minus 32 into 5 by 9. What will happen? 77 minus 32 into 5 by 9. So this will be 45 into 5 by 9. So here also you are able to do 9 1 jar, 9 5 jar. So 25. So by using direct formula also, or if you remember only this formula, by this formula also you can solve it. So just you have to keep in mind the temperature in degree Fahrenheit is equal to 9 by 5 into C plus 32. Thank you.